हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू मैग्नोटेक यूट्यूब चैनल। फ्रेंड्स, आवर टुडेज टॉपिक इज सेंट्रीफ्यूगल क्लच एंड वी हैड ऑलरेडी कंप्लीटेड सिंगल प्लेट क्लच एंड कॉन क्लच फॉर द अमाउंट ऑफ टॉर्क ट्रांसमिट इक्वेशंस, राइट। सो लेट अस स्टार्ट विद द सेंट्रीफ्यूगल क्लच। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल लेट अस सी द वर्किंग ऑफ सेंट्रीफ्यूगल क्लच। सो फ्रेंड्स, इन दिस फिगर यू कैन सी हियर दिस इज अ ड्राइविंग शाफ्ट एंड दिस इज अ ड्रिवन शाफ्ट। सो ड्राइविंग शाफ्ट इज अटैच्ड विथ दिस शूज एंड यू कैन सी हियर इन अ फोर शूज इट इज कनेक्टेड विद द स्प्रिंग। ओके, सो देर इज सम स्टिफनेस ऑफ स्प्रिंग अकॉर्डिंग टू द डिजाइन। Now, when the driving shaft is rotated, similarly, this shoes is also rotated at particular RPM, okay? And at that time, this cover plate, or we can say this is drum, is not rotated, okay? So it's in a steady condition and driving shaft is only rotated at particular speed, okay? Now, as per the centrifugal name, okay, when the speed is increased at particular level, say particular 1000 RPM, this is not, shoes are not comes to outside, but above the 1000 RPM, shoes comes to out and it is stick with this drum. Okay, you can see here, this is a lining material, okay, in four shoes and it stick with the drum. Okay, and parallelly drum also rotate, or we can say cover plate is also rotate, and similarly with the cover plate driven shaft is rotated. So we can rotate driven shaft by using driving shaft through this shoes and with the help of centrifugal force which moves the shoes outside. Okay, this shoes will comes to outside due to centrifugal force, and that's why the name of this clutch is centrifugal clutch. Okay, now there are particular stiffness of the spring, which is we can say spring force. Here you can see PS is the spring force, okay, which having a force on inner side, and at particular speed there is a outward side force that is called the PC. So PC is the outward side force and PS that is the spring force which is inside. Okay, so if we want to rotate this drum, it should have the force PC minus PS. Okay, hope you understand, PC minus PS. So PC should be more than PS, then this drum start to rotate. Now let us understand more clearly. It's clearly, so here M is the mass of each shoes, N is the number of shoes. As per the design, we can provide 6 number of shoes, okay, 4 number of shoes. So R is the radial distance, it's a distance of center of gravity of the shoes. It means somewhere here it is a gravity of this particular shoes, or we can say spider. So it is over here R from the center, and capital R is the inside radius of the pulley rim. So this is a pulley rim, and up to here, center to here, it's a R, okay, capital R, inside radius of the pulley rim. So up to inside radius, okay, actually in figure you, okay, so let me clear, it is inside, okay. So N is the running speed of the pulley in RPM, and omega is the angular running speed of the pulley in radian per second, that is 2 pi n upon 60 radian per second, and omega 1, that is the angular speed at which the engagement begins. Okay, so when the engagement begins, it's when this shoes stick with this drum, then it start with the rotating. Okay, then mu is the coefficient of friction between the shoes and rim. Okay, now let us see the equations, what it says. So here we know the centrifugal force acting on each shoe at the running speed. So as I told you, our running speed should be higher, our running speed should be higher the spring force PS, that is the spring force, then the drum is rotate. Okay, outer drum is rotate. So here the net outward force, that is PC minus PS. So PS, that is a spring force which is inside, and PC, that is the outward force. So here net outward radial force is PC minus PS. Okay, now The frictional force, now if we add the coefficient of friction of this material, then F is equal to mu Pc minus Ps. Now frictional torque T is equal to Tf, we can say frictional torque T is equal to F into R. So if we put the value of F here, then it is mu Pc minus Ps into R. So R is the capital R, so it's a center to rim distance, okay. So here capital R, and the frictional torque transmitted T is equal to mu Pc minus Ps R into N. So N is the number of shoes, like I told you 4, 6, whatever. So this is a basic equation for amount of torque transmit in a centrifugal clutch. Now next is size of the shoe. So it is required to know what should be the size of shoe. Okay, it's maybe 4 number 6 number, then what should be the size? So L is the length of contact of the shoes. So L here, it is the length of contact. B is the width of shoes, which we cannot see from here, but we can see from the side view. Okay, so B is the width of the shoe. Now R is the contact radius of the shoes, like you know, okay, it is the this one, okay, as we have discussed. Theta is the angle of these shoes, and P is the intensity of pressure exerted on the shoe. So here pressure P, small p, that is the intensity of pressure, okay. And if it is not given in the example, we should consider it as a 0.1 newton per mm square. Now as we know that theta is equal to L by R, so theta is equal to L by R, so L is equal to, we can say, theta into R, right. And area of the contact of shoes, it means the area of contact, it means this L into width, so L into B, and the force with which the shoes pass against the rim, that is area into pressure, okay. So here F is equal to, we can say, force is equal to area into pressure, so LB into P, okay. Now we can say that the LBP is equal to, this means the force, this is the same like F is equal to FC minus FS, or we can say PC minus PS. This P, it's a force, it's not a pressure, right? This is the pressure P, okay. So you should differentiate this one, small p, that is the pressure, and capital P here, it is a force, okay. So PC, that is the centrifugal force, and PS, that is the spring force, okay. So we can say LBP is equal to PC minus PS, and by this way we can find out length or maybe width as per the given data. So this is basically about the centrifugal clutch. So we have discussed working of centrifugal clutch, then we have derived the torque transmission equation for the centrifugal clutch, and then we have seen the equation for the find out the size of the shoes. Now in the next video I will show you that different clutch examples, okay. So friends, if you like this video, please the like button and share this video to your friends, and don't forget to subscribe. Thank you. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.